My name is Maki Niihori from Indiana University. I am introducing our paper entitled Mitochondria as a Primary Determinant of Angiogenic Modality in Pulmonary Arterial Hypertension. Pulmonary arterial hypertension is a life-threatening condition with unmet clinical needs. The molecular mechanisms driving the remodeling of pulmonary arteries remain unclear. Mitochondrial dysfunction is one of the known contributors to the complex PAH pathobiology, although whether it is a sign of a collateral damage or plays a causative role in PAH remains unknown. It has been previously observed that the patient with a severe mitochondrial dysfunction due to the point mutation in the NFU1 protein develop PAH in 70% of cases, which is extremely high compared to the low PAH prevalence in normal population. NFU1, a critical player in iron sulfur cluster biosynthesis, is required for an adequate activity of mitochondrial respiratory complexes and lipoic acid synthase. The last is produced as a lipoic acid, serving as a critical cofactor for several mitochondrial enzymes. By reproducing the same mutation in SDRAS, we found that NFU1 insufficiency causes severe mitochondrial dysfunction. Most importantly, this mitochondrial dysfunction spontaneously initiated a progressive PAH phenotype. The three-dimensional micro-CT analysis revealed a severe impaired pulmonary vasculature network of NFU1 mutants, characterized by a significant loss of small PAs and vaso-obliterative disease. Similar changes in the pulmonary vasculature are observed in PH patients. To investigate the contribution of the mitochondrial dysfunction and specifically the NFU1 LA signaling axis on the impaired angiogenesis, we established a protocol for a chronic LA supplementation in drinking water. The LA treatment significantly improved mitochondrial respiration. It has also preserved the pulmonary vasculature network at the control level, protected integrity of small PAs, and prevented vaso-obliteration. Finally, the LA therapy was sufficient to completely prevent the development of PAH phenotype in NFU1 mutants. The translational aspect of this study is confirmed by the discovery of previously unrecognized decrease in NFU1 protein level and PTH lipoation in the lungs of idiopathic PAH patients. Furthermore, the seahorse mitostress assay performed on the PAECs isolated from PAH patients revealed that even an acute exposure to LA significantly improved mitochondrial function in PAH patients. In summary, mitochondrial dysfunction plays a causative role in the disrupted angiogenesis associated with PAH phenotype. Restoring LA bioavailability is sufficient to maintain pulmonary angiogenesis at control level and prevents the development of progressive PAH phenotype. NFU1 deficiency observed in idiopathic PAH patient underscores the relevance of this study to cases beyond those with NFU1 mutations. Lipoic acid supplementation restores mitochondrial function in pulmonary artery endothelial cells derived from PAH patient, suggesting its potential as a therapeutic approach. On behalf of all the authors, I would like to express our gratitude to all contributors to this research. Thank you.